I'm inventor of several patents, articles, presentations in congresses, scientist committees, and we have some awards. The first award, Archimedes, is a national award that we got for a development of a construction process of one bridge. These three awards are a national award to the best doctoral thesis in the construction engineering area. And this year we have won two awards from the European Union, from the LIFE program. We had a project in 2011, and this project won one award as one of the best 25 projects of the LIFE proposal, and the other award was selected by the European citizens as the best project from the point of view of the European citizens. About the funding, you can see here that most of the funds have gone from projects with companies, but we have also some 20% of the funds from competitive national projects, from the mainly this research council, national research council goals, and now we are focusing our efforts in European projects, because due to the economic crisis, the things in Spain are really, but now are improving. You know that we are without government near to a year, but now we are improving.
Yes.
Yes. So here you can see the evolution of the funding, and in 2012 was the worst year when the actual government appears and cut all the funds to research. The evolution of funding in competitive calls, 2015 we had some projects from Europe, for this reason we have here an increment of the funding. And now I want to wonder about the publications. It is my EH factor in Google Scholar, 18. In Scopus I have an H factor of 13. And in Web of Science, the H factor is 11. You know, usually they are decreasing. Web of Science is stronger for these things. I have participated in the publications of several books. And I especially want to remark this book. It's like a Syria collection of books here in the UK. It was a book published from the Ministry of Public Works, and it is about the design of riprap wall, or it's like a rocks wall, okay? That they are commonly used in Cantabria, in our region. I'm also co-author of several papers in research journals, 87 articles in journals with JCR Index, 10 in XCR, with different impacts, 43 of them are in the first quarter. The journals where I'm publishing the articles, they are, the first one is Construction and Building Materials, but I have published my articles in other journals in more related with the activity of car, water science technology, applied thermal engineering, geotextiles and geomembranes, or applied energy. And as I have said before, I'm an inventor of several patents or co-inventor. Patents for slope stabilization systems, slope treatment plant, sand test device. It is a procedure to push breaches, and it is related with the green infrastructure. Is the SCPT, a system for collection, pretreatment, and treatment of water. I will talk later about this project. We develop also software for the companies. The companies who contract us to develop products usually have to sell them, and we developed the software that designed the product software, the systems. Some utility models, and here you can see a permeable concrete block using by a company of Cantabria in the catalog of permeable pavements. And now I will talk briefly about the research lines. We have seven research lines. I work mainly in those five: construction of new pavement structures, implementation of a slope protection and stabilization systems in construction, application of geosynthetics in construction, green infrastructure, construction of sustainable green structures, and finally construction applied of to the development of energy technologies. Yeah. The other two research lines, the first one is online education for engineers. We work developing online courses for the continuous professional development of the technicians of the main construction companies in Spain. We develop online courses about management, about the construction processes of tunnels, impermeabilizations, etc. And we also develop new constructive systems as pushing bridges or new processes to build tunnels. Regarding my main research line, the construction of new pavement structures, we are focusing the development of worn and half worn mixes, and also the use of industrial byproducts. And all European projects by the moment are most of them focused in this research line. I developed my thesis in the research line number 4, slope stabilization, protection and stabilization system. I developed a flexible system to stabilize and to the erosion control in the slopes. Due to we have a geosynthetic lab, it is a transversal line that this research line has applications, for example, in reinforcement pavements with geogrids or in filtering system in green infrastructure. Okay. Yes, I will talk after about several projects of permeable pavements. Mainly we have work in the construction of sustainable drainage system, but focused mainly in permeable pavements. And the last research line is the construction of sustainable energy infrastructures. Here we have developed some systems using geothermal energy and the combination of geothermal energy with sites. So, our network in our research group, we are members of several technological platforms that by the end they are lobbies in the construction sectors. We work with the main construction companies of Spain, also with companies from Europe, several technological centers from Spain, from Germany, from US. We have relation with several universities, Coventry, Nottingham, all the universities involved in the Master in European Construction Engineering, and I have very good relations with several universities of Chile also, and Brazil. With public institutions, as the Federal Highway Administration, BTA, or finally advisory boards, as for example the European Road Federation or the European Asphalt Pavement Association, the International Geosynthetic Society, etc. Resources. We have a European project office that help us a lot when we apply for our European projects. We have two offices, one in Cantabria, the university, and another one in Brussels. So several kickoff meetings of our projects are in our office of Brussels. We have also an international relations office for the general internationalization of the university, mainly focus in students and lecturers, exchanges of students and lecturers. We have an international rate property offices or labs. Maybe the best value is the network. Okay, now I will be focused more in the research activities. I will talk about two research lines and the projects of two research lines. The first one is slope protection and stabilization systems and during the green infrastructure. In a slope stabilization system, we work mainly in three areas. The first one is erosion control of slopes. We use geocells to control the erosion, geomats, and the normal revegetation techniques to control the erosion in slopes. The other area that we are working is the slope stabilization. We develop our companies flexible and green systems. You can see here a rock mess for the stabilization of a slope just at the end of the construction, and here how can be regenerated. So the visual impact is really, really low. These systems are mainly they mainly work as this scheme. You have a rock mesh, the reinforcement cables for the transmission of the loads inside of the slope, and the anchors. The anchors transmit these loads inside of the slope. Here you have a scheme of the forces. Okay? So it is the real systems. Here you have the reinforcement rope and some other mess. Probably, I don't know if you can see here, but we have put in this case three meshes. There is a geosynthetic at the bottom, a steel mesh, and a rope cable to control small particles, erosion control, to improve the regeneration of the slope. Okay. And of course the rope mesh is to reinforce and to support the load of the instabilized load of the slope. Here we some of all the block mesh. It is a patent. This is a sample for the rope mesh. Also this plate, and we have test the mesh in a field using these strong gauge devices. Okay, because we need to know if the results from our numerical models are more or less the same that of the value that we are measuring in field. And also it is part of my PhD thesis, three systems to test the mechanical properties of the here you can see the installation process of this flexible system. Initially you have to put the mesh over the slope, after the reinforced ropes you have to do the perforation to build the holes for the anchors, put the mortar inside of the anchors, pre-stress the system, and finally you should do the regeneration of the system. Okay, and here you can see some pictures of the final places. It is in a railway area, so you don't need to cut the traffic of the trains. You can work at the same time. I want to put also these pictures because of the word flexible. They work really like a glove because they can be adapted very well to the surface. You don't need a flat surface. Okay, so it can control very well the erosion, and it can apply a good pressure over the surface of the slope, and they could work as an active systems. The other area is the rock fall protection. Okay, in this case, we are waiting for the rocks. We are designing rock fall barriers. Here you can see some of them. It is a gallery, and this gallery will intercept vertical fallings of rocks. So we work in the development, in the theoretical development of the system. We develop the components also. We can do numerical simulation of the mechanical properties of the mesh, and also we can accreditate the system according to the standards, European standards. Give me a minute to see this video. Oh, it's here. Sorry. Where's the video? Oh, sorry. We were testing this barrier that we developed for a Cantabrian company. So we are trying to prevent that type of risks. Okay. The rock fall barrier can surely intercept these rocks near to the roads, or when you have some houses near to the slopes. And they work mainly by deformation and absorption of energy. Here it is the energy dissipator. It is one of our best patents.
Okay. You need to remove that later.
So, regarding the construction of sustainable drainage structures, we have developed several research projects, some with companies, but most of them have been funded by the National Council. National Research Council. Yes. So, in 2002, I came to Coventry University to teach, to lecture 1 week in the master, and the other professor, Francisco in Cantabria, told me, talk with Keith Chapman and ask what are they doing in research, because at this moment we had few research in Cantabria. We were working only in slope stabilization systems, and for instance, Francisco, we are working more time outside of the university at this moment. So I was talking with Keith, and Keith told me, okay, maybe you can talk with John Davis, Alan Newman, that they are working in sustainable urban drainage systems. They showed me the laboratory, the field test that they had at the back of the civil engineering school, and I said, why not? We can check how it works in Cantabria, in Spain, with the environmental conditions. It was totally new for us. Nobody knew the permeable pavements. And I applied to the National Council Research Project for this project, the FIRICA project. The aims of this project were the development of new permeable pavement structures using recycled aggregates. Also, we want to analyze the microbial communities that will do the biodegradation of hydrocarbons. And we think that we should do a testing if it's possible in real scale. Finally, we built 8 experimental permeable parking bays that were used to test to check the results. So the main results of the project were the hydrological behavior and clogging potential of permeable pavements, we found that it were directly related to the pavement design and used materials. Other result was, for example, that the geosynthetic thickness is the main parameter influencing biofilm generation. Sorry. Here you can see a test lab where you check several type of geosynthetics. The next project was the design, research and instrumentation of parking lots built with hydrocarbon degrading pervious pavements. In this project, the walls was the design of a parking area with hydrocarbons, degrading permeable pavements. We wanted to do monitorization of the water quality and quantity parameters, the study of the capacity to storage water, and analyze the hydrocarbons degradation capacity. In this case, in collaboration with one company also, we built 45 parking bays. They were designed for work for rainwater harvesting purposes. We used 5 different permeable surfaces and 3 different geotextiles, because we wanted to assess the influence in the hydrological behavior of the permeable pavements. In this case, one of the surface work were concrete blocks provided by Hanson Fonpei, a UK company. The results of the project where the impact of the surface layer is greater than that of a geotextile. The permeable surface can be clustered in mainly the continuous surface, porous concrete and porous asphalt. The evapotranspiration show with the limited effects on the storage water, taking into account oceanic climates, and the water quality washing out for water reuse according to the standards to the Spanish law. The next project was also a national project funded by the Research Council. It was the TRAPI. The main aim of this project was the development of a device to be placed in sewer system for catchment, pretreatment, and treatment of runoff containing hydrocarbons spilled from impervious pavements. We developed several designs. We used numerical simulation to assess that designs, and finally we built a prototype of this system. The results were that the system for collection, pretreatment and treatment, the SCPT that I saw it before in the patents slides, was designed for being installed in impervious parking areas for manage polluted surfaces runoff. It has 3 different chambers, one geotextile layer which filter the inflow water. The CPT was capable to reduce the pollution of the main events up to 90%, and the number of geotextile layers showed that the most influencing parameter in the pollutants is to have more or less geotextile layers. A company that was doing a new hotel in an environmental protected area asked us to build some compensatory environmental solutions in the area of the hotel, and at the same time they wanted to do some research. So we suggest them to do some permeable parking bays, and also some green infrastructure additional to control the pollutants and the hydrocarbons of the traffic that will be there. So these projects start with the money, with the fund of this company. The main aims of the projects was the design of sustainable drainage structures, the monitoring of the water quality, and analyze the influence of climate conditions. Finally, we built 20 meters of experimental stretches. The main results of the project is that the old fallout was less polluted than in the conventional concrete ditch, that the offload water from both sites can be reused, and that the offload from filtered drain system is less polluted than the outflow from the soil. Other project, our permeable pavements, is design, control and monitoring of pervious pavements built with slag and steel waste. In this case, we used in the base of the permeable pavements both slag and reservoirs. We wanted also monitoring the water quality and analyze how the both slab works as a reservoir. The main results of the project were that after 2 years of monitoring the water quality parameters allows the water to be reused, and the both slab aggregates should be treated previously of to be placed in the porous pavement systems in order to reduce the electric conductivity and the pH. And according with our results, finally we think that the both slag may be more useful in if they are used in a base layer where the water content is lower than in a reservoir layer. Now we started to change a little bit with this project. It is the VEA project, is also a council research project. The main aim of this project was to study the rainwater storage capacity of permeable pavements in order to use this water for non-potable uses or in low enthalpy general geothermal systems. The main results of the project, several permeable pavements were compared, and all the permeable pavements showed great infiltration and water storage capacity, and the combination of a porous asphalt surface and a limestone gravel surface provided the best insulation. Now this project, also funded by the national government, I wasn't the main researcher of this project, Jorge was the main researcher. The general purpose of this project was to improve the hydrological rehabilitation of urban roads so that they can withstand the design traffic and also help to prevent the flooding and diffuse pollution. And one PhD thesis has been developed inside of this project, created by Jorge and Sue Charlesworth, and it was presented. The Viva will be next week, and you will be there. Okay. The main result: the subbase layer was found to influence the stormwater rotation capacity of porous permeable system. Pervious pavement system, mainly in the first time of the construction, and we also developed a multi-criteria decision-making model to develop the select porous pavement system according with the three pillars of the sustainability: environmental, society, and economy. And the last one, surprise, is just running, and now this project we develop a comprehensive risk analysis to identify and assess the major threats related to urban surface that should be addressed in the future. Okay, we will develop also a multi-criteria design model to analyze the risks, and it is the first project where we are introducing resilience as a part of our research. We started with sustainability, after the thermal energy, alternative energy, and now we are changing to resilience. So, it is the second part. Maybe you need a cup of coffee. Here you have it.